ARESxGOD here, and it's time to talk about the latest episode from the Irregular at Magic High School. Now, this episode seems to be focused around the parasites, mainly Pixie, and the choice she made, how she wants to live her life moving forward. And Honoka's powers seems to be very important and surprising in a way. A lot of people are getting interested into it. So, let's get into the episode and see what happens. Now, firstly, we see that Maya Yotsuba has been working behind scenes to interfere with the USNA, and there's also an incident with a vessel with a high-ranking officer between the Japanese, the USNA, and Maya Yotsuba seems to be the one that put things into motion, and she actually got Miyuki involved because she called her beforehand, and Miyuki had to pretend in front of Tatsuya that she didn't know about the incident. Now, we also see that Miyuki has a lot of stuff on her mind. She's worried about having to lie to Tatsuya, worried what it means, her position, with her being the next leader of the Yotsuba clan, what she has to do, even thinking about marrying, having kids. But she doesn't want to do that because she feels like she belongs to Tatsuya, and Tatsuya is supposed to be the only one who's allowed to touch her, how much she cares about him. Now, I don't know how that's gonna work since they're brother and sister, unless they reveal at some point they're not blood related in a way. I really hope we're gonna get an episode that focuses a lot on their backstory, on the Yotsuba clan. We have so many questions on the Yotsuba, especially Maya, Tatsuya's mother, so many stuff we need to talk about there. Hopefully we're gonna get an episode about this. But yeah, she's very much in love with Tatsuya, if we haven't figured it out so far since season 1. She's willing to do anything and everything for him. But yeah, we really need that Yotsuba-focused episode, and hopefully we're gonna get it. Now, we have a conversation with Tatsuya and Pixie. I want to talk about the parasites, the incident, how exactly they work, and what causes the blood loss. We find out that the blood loss, it's not the focus or wasn't intentional, it's just a byproduct of their propagation effect, how they multiply, how they live on, and how they possess hosts in this case. We also see they don't really possess the body, they try and focus on the mental body, but they haven't really been successful so far. There have been a lot of issues. And it seems they cut a part of themselves, and that's how they propagate forward. But it hasn't really been a success, and they don't really know why exactly it doesn't work. Not even themselves know why the process doesn't work. And we see when they do the propagation effect, they use the blood to modify the body, and that's why the blood appears to be a blood loss, because they use it as a form of matter or energy to modify the host body, to allow them to possess it in a way. And they also try, like I said, try to reach the mental body in a way to control the mind mainly, not just an organ of the host. But yeah, it seems to fail when they're trying to propagate, and nobody really knows why, not even themselves. So another big question with the parasites: what exactly do they want mainly? Why doesn't their propagation process work? So many questions about them. Now, also see that there's no big leadership, like a hierarchy in their civilization. They're also at the same time individuals and a group. They're linked in a way in a hive mind, but not just they also have their own individuality and a hive mind at the same time. Now, we see that the other parasites are also looking for Pixie, and she doesn't have their locations. Now, also get to see the other parasites a bit doing this. I don't know, at first I thought it was somebody else, but then they're doing a weird dance, trying to wake up more parasites, and apparently that's Chinese necromancy, being able to revive them in a way, even if they're body died, they're still able to control the body even after death in a way with this Chinese necromancy thing. I'm not sure how it works, it wasn't exactly explained and what happened, but I don't know, maybe they're gonna tell us at some point with this character. We later find his name, Martem. Apparently he was a bit in charge of that parasite group, even though they said they don't have any leadership. And they want to take back their missing comrade, and in this case, talking about Pixie. Now, back with Pixie and Tatsuya. After their conversation, I like that Tatsuya told Pixie to have a change of clothes. And for him, it didn't faze him. Yes, Pixie is a robot, but she's also at the same time a female. And the more we see, she's starting to become an actual person, an individual, not just a robot being controlled by a parasite. This causes Miyuki to get jealous because Tatsuya wasn't embarrassed and, like I said, didn't faze him with Pixie changing clothes in front of him. Makes him turn around. He changes clothes and she actually looks pretty cute, if I do say so myself. You can't even tell she's a robot with a parasite. I know that's the title of the next light novel. My robot has a parasite inside it. What do I do now? Something along those lines. But yeah, she's looking very, very cute. She changes. And we see that their next location to actually be able to draw out the parasites is Aoyama Cemetery, because they're able to draw in ghosts there. They also let know Leo, Erika, and Miki. And Erika apparently was prepared for this. She has a bunch of her own soldiers or troop there, saying a mission is gonna start. I don't know what exactly Erika's planning, if Tatsuya even knows what Erika is doing. I feel like she's still trying to get revenge for what happened to Leo, maybe going a bit off script to compared to what everybody else is trying to do. Now, after the mission failed with Virginia and Lina, we see Colonel Virginia thinking about what happened. Seemed like she woke up like she was drugged in a way, headaches, wasn't feeling very good, blanks in memories, stuff like that. And now she also has a visit from somebody from the Yotsuba clan, Ayako Kuroba, who's your loli goth killer girl. Apparently that's the impression I got from her, the way she was behaving, acting, and talking, very suave a bit and threatening at the same time. Now, the reason why she's there, she wants to ask Virginia to stop her interference with their magicians, basically put a stop to their missions, because they want to reach a friendship in a way. I don't know, but they're also a bit threats reading between the line. The question that Ayako asked the colonel was, did you sleep well last night? And like I said, Virginia had her sleep issues with what happened to her when she went missing. Threats, implications, and so even Virginia got a bit attacked. And Ayako just played it off. I was just worried about your well-being and so on. I liked how she was handling the situation. She was completely in control, honestly. I'm curious how Maya would have handled. I'd love to see more Maya Yotsuba, because she seems very, very intimidating, but maybe in that Yotsuba clan episode. Now, they reach an agreement in a way, as a compromise. If Virginia agrees to this friendship and stop the interference, they're gonna owe a favor to Virginia in the future if she ever needs help with something. I don't know if the deal is gonna stand, what this favor is gonna be, what Maya is planning. But I'm very curious. It seems the 10 clans, the 10 master clans, are getting a lot more involved, especially the Yotsuba. Now, we also have Tatsuya under surveillance. He senses it. We see that it's Section 3, the ones that are connected to Saegusa. Another question there, another one of the 10 master clans. Does Saegusa Mayumi actually, does she know what her father is doing? What exactly does he want with capturing a parasite, like we found out a few episodes ago? But yeah, they seem to be keeping Tatsuya under surveillance. I liked how Honoka was able to deal with them, putting them to sleep. Her power got me very interested, even from from there, and while she was taking care of the Section 3 guys, something curious happened. We have Fujibayashi, the girl from the military. She was also watching, and with her was Kudo, the old Sly Fox we had a few episodes ago, who was above the 10 Master Clans, sort of like the leadership. I think he stepped down, if I remember correctly, something along those lines, but he's one of the most influential people in the Irregular world, so to say. And he's very adept at using his powers and very observational. Now, he also makes a very interesting comment about Honoka, saying she might be something along the lines of elements, bloodlines of light. I'm not sure what exactly that means, but he got very interested in Honoka. Now, back to the main group where the meeting happened, so to say, with three parasites, in this case being Marta and two of the other ones, meeting with Tatsuya's group, with Miyuki, Honoka and Pixie, and they want to call a truce, but they chose their words very carefully, and Tatsuya picked up on it, very astute. And they want, like I said, a truce, but they also want the robot in return for them to stop attacking magicians, and this is where the key part, the way they chose their words, magicians, happened. Now, the main reason they want the robot is to release the parasite that's inside by destroying the host, because if you destroy the host, the parasite is freed and is able to take up a new host. Now, I liked the way Tatsuya handled the situation. He didn't instantly say no, and I was expecting that, but I still liked it quite a lot, because he asks Pixie directly, and like I said, she's starting to become her own person, asks her, what do you want? Now, she flat out refuses, saying, I belong to you, I don't care where my feelings that created my core came from, I want to live my life the way it is now, I don't want to stop being myself. And like I said, I'm very interested to see how Pixie is gonna develop moving forward. I hope she's gonna remain part of the students, the school group that Tatsuya is part of, because I'm starting to like her. Her and Honoka might still have a connection, but I'll get to that. Now, after Pixie pours out her feelings, so to say, to Tatsuya, he was expecting the same answer, honestly, but doesn't tell him instantly no. And this is where he starts breaking down this truce. The question, why did you only mention the magicians, asks Tatsuya Marte. Now, Marte kind of starts going on his speech, how humans see magicians only as tools, and they see humans the same way. I feel like he was going on his villain speech over there, the way he views the world, his own philosophy, but basically he was a hypocrite. And he was still gonna hurt humans even after. That's why he only specified the magicians. He was planning to put the parasites still in humans even if he couldn't touch magicians. But Tatsuya wasn't having any of it. He even said, you've already hurt my friends before. Why should I take your word for it? You haven't even apologized. So yeah, Marte basically was a scum. He was just trying to get his way without actually sticking to his word. This is where the negotiations break down. Not like they were gonna get anywhere, because one party wasn't being truthful and the other one wasn't willing to sacrifice a person, because I'm starting to consider Pixie a person moving forward. But yeah, they start getting into a fight. Now, Tatsuya has to take care of Marte without destroying his body, because if you destroy the body, like I mentioned, the parasite is free, so he didn't want to let him escape. Now, he goes after his heart, thinking of the lessons he had from Kokonoe and his past experiences, just to disable the body in a way. Now, Miyuki is also able to freeze one of them. Just remember that, the one who was frozen by Miyuki. On the other side, we have Pixie protecting Honoka. Honoka still wanting to help Tatsuya. Is very much in love with him. The entire episode she was thinking how she can be of help to him, and this is where her power seems to do something weird. Everybody was surprised by it. Her earrings started glowing. Everything started glowing. There seems to still be a connection between Honoka and Pixie. I don't know what's up with that. But yeah, everything, like I said, started glowing. They were able to take care of that parasite. Even Tatsuya was surprised by this power, saying, wait, it can be what I'm thinking. What exactly is it? Stuff like that. And like I mentioned, the one who was frozen, the ice melted when Honoka's power was activated. Now, how was she able to do that? What exactly her power is? Those element bloodlines of light that Kudo mentioned. Maybe her power is this something special. A lot of people seem to know about it in a way. Wanted, very surprised that somebody actually has it. I don't know, Honoka, what exactly do you have, but hopefully you're gonna be able to master it, because it seems to be very powerful and a lot of people might want it, but you have Tatsuya on your side. So yeah, I'm very curious about Honoka, how she was able to melt Miyuki's ice, what exactly her power is. I'm glad that Pixie is probably gonna be able to stay with the group, and she's starting to become her own person, even though she's still very subservient to Tatsuya, willing to do everything for him as per Honoka's feelings when she woke up. Yeah, overall an interesting episode. We found out more about the parasites, a lot more questions. Also, the clans are starting to move. Feels like everything is getting into motion and things are getting a lot more complicated, even on the political side and the individual side in this case. So yeah, what do you guys think about the episode? Let me know in the comments below, especially about Pixie. And thank you for watching. Remember to like and subscribe, it really helps me quite a lot. And you guys get the latest videos on the series I follow. Now, keep enjoying the Irregular at Magic High School. I'll see you again on the next one. Bye bye.